enough is enough. This can't go on any longer, and as the famous saying goes, sunlight is the best disinfectant. So, here we go. I'm currently being legally abused and intimidated into silence by a former employer. This has been going on for a while now, and I simply cannot live in darkness for another day. This kind of harassment at the hands of the powerful isn't just designed to financially ruin somebody, it's designed to cripple their soul. Now, I wasn't about to put my family on embarking upon a journey down that road.
That gentleman you just heard from was Jared Mitello, a former employee of Steven Crowder's, who also goes by Jared Monroe, or not gay Jared. Now, earlier this week, he released a video on X accusing his former employer of fostering a toxic and abusive work environment. While Monroe never specifically named Crowder in the video, he worked for the conservative host between 2014 and 2018. And it's obvious that's who he's talking about. Monroe alleges that Crowder has subjected him to years of legal abuse following his departure from the company. And as a result, he's now soliciting donations in order to pay his legal bills and prevent the financial ruin of his family. Let's hear from him and more of what he has to say.
I voluntarily left my job after deciding I can no longer put myself or my growing family through the toxic and abusive work environment I had endured for years. This place was and is to this day a workplace rife with sexual misconduct, degeneracy, and aggression. The things I saw, the things done to me, and the things I witnessed my employer do to others were disgusting, shocking, and utterly indefensible. This all took a serious toll on my personal health. To the point near the end of my tenure, the work environment had become so toxic that I had to be admitted into a heart hospital. And after many tests, I was ultimately put on anti-anxiety medication. This condition was something new to me. I had no history of it prior to my employment there and have never been treated for it since.
Monroe says he basically says that the situation at work was so terrible that he decided to resign while his wife was pregnant. That's how bad it was. He says that he knew he couldn't stay with the company, but Crowder didn't make it easy for him to leave either. Monroe alleged that he was bullied into signing an aggressive separation agreement after a drawn out legal fight in which Crowder's lawyers argued he should be blocked from working in media anywhere in the world for 2 years, have his personal Twitter account seized, and turn over all his personal production equipment that he paid for himself. Monroe explains that he eventually gave in to Crowder's demands because not doing so would rack up more legal fees. He claims he eventually accepted a deal with Crowder that paid him no money and enforced a non-compete and non-disparagement clause. But it didn't end there.
The primary reason I signed the NDA was for a small carve out in the non-compete clause, which allowed me to freely seek employment using some of my skill sets at another specific company. At least I could feed my family. That provision, however, was a lie. And upon starting my new job at the new said company, I was giving another one of these, a cease and desist, and was promptly unlawfully terminated from that position. While my supposed non-compete expired after 2 years, unfortunately, the most egregious part of my NDA, the part that silences my free speech, has no expiration.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us.
In October of 2023, 5 years after Monroe left Ladder with Crowder, he was served another cease and desist, which threatened legal action if he did not immediately cease all communications with others about the company. In addition to that, Monroe was also served a Rule 202 petition, which demanded he be subjected to a deposition under oath in which lawyers could question him about his communications, as well as hand over documents of any and all communications about the company. Now, why did this happen 5 years after he quit? If you notice the timeline, the cease and desist came right after the initial allegations of bullying, inappropriate drug use, and lewd sexual workplace misconduct at Louder with Crowder. And it came to light which we of course covered here at TYT.
Steven Crowder allegedly created an incredibly inappropriate and hostile workplace where he exposed his genitals to employees and openly exchanged drugs. Now, Mediaite spoke to five individuals, former staffers of Steven Crowder's. They are anonymous. They are not named in the piece. There's also one anonymous source close to Crowder. Now, one of those former employees actually showed Mediaite the unsolicited and sexually explicit text messages he received from Crowder, including images of Crowder's genitalia.
Yeah, that report came out in July of 2023, and afterward, Crowder went on the warpath, on a warpath. After that report, sources told Mediaite that Crowder sought to crack down on leaks to media outlets. He sent draconian non-disclosure agreements to his current staff with a $100,000 breach of contract penalty. Monroe has refused to comply with the current cease and desist and Rule 202 petition. However, last week, Crowder's demand for Monroe's deposition and cooperation in handing over the documents was awarded by the court, which is why Monroe is now raising money for his legal battle. Monroe says that money is also meant to help him pay for his countersuit against Crowder to release him from his non-disclosure agreement. One former Louder with Crowder employee told Mediaite, quote, "Jared isn't a rich man. He knows Steven has millions of dollars and an army of lawyers. Steven is extremely vindictive and always looks for any opportunity to get back at anyone he feels has wronged him. Even just leaving the show he views as a huge betrayal. Jared is basically faced with an abusive ex-boss who wants to make his life a living hell and has the funds to do so." And look, much of the reaction to Monroe from both sides of the political spectrum have been supportive. There are a few examples of people not being supportive, but to be fair, Crowder has a lot of enemies, including former Daily Wire host Candace Owens, who tweeted in response to Monroe's video, "Wait till they find out what he's been doing to his wife. I never edited my opinion on Steven Crowder because I knew that everything would eventually be revealed. This really is going to be a year of revelations." All right, I guess hold on to your butts for that. Owens also apparently donated to his legal fund, and as of this morning, Monroe reached 80% of his fundraising goal. And just to address what Owens was implying about Crowder's treatment of his wife, it is true that he's going through a horribly tumultuous divorce. There are allegations of spousal abuse and a bitter custody battle for the twins the couple share. There are reports that Crowder is actually demanding full custody, which I personally find insane. Last year in April, journalist Yasser Ali released a Ring camera video of Crowder berating his very pregnant wife. Her family alleges that she hid his emotionally abusive behavior for years. And look, we don't know everything that went down in their marriage. And to be honest with you, I'd rather not speculate on matters that are that personal and private. We also don't know all the details about the type of workplace environment that Crowder fostered. What we do know is that there is an obvious trend in the allegations made against him, with every single one pointing to Crowder's alleged controlling and toxic behavior. If Monroe's allegations against Crowder are proven to be true, it does also make his whole Daily Wire debacle even more hilarious. Remember, Crowder was the guy who was offered $50 million, an insane and unwarranted sum of money, to host a show on the conservative network. He threw a weird fit about it because the Daily Wire's opening offer included a provision that would penalize his compensation if the show, you know, faced an advertiser boycott or loss of revenue from demonetization, something Crowder tends to egg on and then whine about. But he had a cover story. He claimed to be publicly trashing the Daily Wire's offer to protect younger and less experienced conservative hosts who might be duped by the Daily Wire into signing unfair contracts. If Monroe's allegations are proven to be true, it clearly appears that Crowder knows a thing or two about unfair and abusive contracts. So I guess we'll wait to see how this all unfolds. But again, if these allegations are proven And I do hope that Monroe is able to defend himself in court. Crowder, it's just more evidence of him not being such a great guy, which would not shock me, which would not surprise me. And so we'll see what happens.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.